The one-dimensional problem that we've been looking at so far is an ideal sort of setting to understand the basic elements of mechanical problems, so kinematics, equilibrium, material response, and the connection between stresses and resultants. But it's extremely idealized because it's one-dimensional, and it is of rather practical utility in a number of applications, but in the general setting it's somewhat limited. And what I'd like to do now is start to look at sort of the general three-dimensional case. So if you have a real three-dimensional object with loads on it, what are the elements that go into it? And to be able to do that, we're going to have to extend a number of our notions that we've been discussing. And the first one that I'd like to discuss an extension of is the extension of our concept of stress. So far what we've been doing is we've been looking at stress as force divided by area. So we have a bar and we apply a load to it, and then we consider that load acting over some cross-sectional area, and then we have defined the stress to be the average value of the force over the area. So the force divided by the area, or the force intensity. Okay, and so this is a very simple concept, and it was good for the one-dimensional case that we were looking at. But we do know that forces, in fact, are vectors. And so suppose the force was in a line completely orthogonal to the cross-section that we were looking at, and now I'd like to think about how we can define stress in this setting. And to define stress in this setting, what we can do is we can consider projecting the vectorial force into a normal component and into a tangential component. So the vector n is the vector that's normal to the cross-sectional area, and t is the vector that's tangential to the cross-sectional area. And so we can project the force down onto these two axes. So we can project it over to here, and we can project it over to here. So this distance here is Fn, and this distance here would be Ft. And we can then use these two components of the force to define two stresses now. So if we take the normal component and divide it by the area, we get what is known as the normal stress, and more precisely the average normal stress, because it gives us an average over the entire cross-section. Eventually, we'll extend our notion of stress to give us a point-wise measure, so each point on the cross-section could have a different stress. But for now, we'll deal with the average normal stress. And so that's just, we use the symbol sigma for that, and that's just the normal force component divided by the area. And then what we call the average shear stress is the tangential component divided by the area, and we'll use the symbol tau to denote the average shear stress. So now we have two different kinds of stresses. We have normal stresses and we have shear stresses. Now, stress, however, is a little bit more complicated than that, and that has to do with the fact that we can select different areas. So suppose I go to some distance down a bar and I look at a point, let's call that point B, and now I pass a section cut through B, and now I can talk about the stresses on this section cut here. And the section cut is angle theta with respect to the long axis of the bar, and I'm applying just a force there. The cross-sectional area is A0, and if I go and compute the stresses on the section cut, let me go ahead and make a free body diagram looking at it from the side. So I'll have my normal direction to the section cut, and I'll have my tangential direction to the section cut. And I can go ahead and compute my components of the force. And to do that, I need to know what the normal vector is precisely. So I can define that in terms of the angle, so sine theta ex, cosine theta ey, and the tangential vector there is minus cosine theta ex plus sine theta ey. And the vectorial version of the force is F times Ex. So I can take my dot products, and I find that the normal component of the force is F sine theta, and the tangential component of the force is minus F cosine theta. This area here of the section cut is A0 divided by sine theta, so the geometry gives me that. So having these three quantities at hand, I can go ahead and look at the normal stress. The normal stress now becomes F over A naught sine squared theta, and tau equals minus F over A naught sine theta cosine theta. So now you can see that I picked a point, I made a section cut at a given angle theta, but the normal stress and the shear stress depend crucially on the angle at which I make those section cuts. Now One thing that we can do is make a plot of this. So here I made a plot of the normal stress, and here I made a plot of the shear stress. And you can see how they change in value going from zero to a max value, back up to a max value, back to zero, depending on the angle of the section cut. And the shear stress does something similar. And we can see that there are maxima and minima for these values. And in the maximal value, for instance, for the normal stress, that occurs when I make my section cut orthogonal to the axis of the bar. And the maxima for the shear stress occur, or the minima occur, when I make my section cut at 45 degrees to the axis of the bar. So we get different values for the maximum shear stress, and we get different values for the maximum normal stress. And it depends on the cutting plane that I make. So this is my point B. It's someplace in the middle of the bar, but I can pass different section cuts through B, and I'm going to get different normal and shear stresses. And one of the reasons that this is really important is because different kinds of material are sensitive to different types of stresses. So brittle materials, for instance, are very sensitive to sigma max, so maximum normal stress. And brittle materials are things like high-strength steels, cast iron, concrete, rock-like materials. They tend to fail due to the normal stresses reaching some type of critical value. Ductile metals tend to be more sensitive to shear stresses, so tau max, so things like aluminum or mild steel. When you're doing design with those types of materials, you're usually interested in tau max as opposed to sigma max.